So today we are going to talk about the second nakshatra, that is Bharani. Bharani, like Ashwini, also falls in Aries, right? And the span is from 13 degree 20 minutes of Aries to 26 degree 40 minutes of Aries. The nakshatra Bharani is symbolized by the female reproductive organ. That is an indicative of, see, it is an indicative of multiple things, right? It is an indicative of multiple things. And one of the primary thing it indicates is emptiness, right? One of the primary thing is isolation. There is never enough of Bharani. Any planet in Bharani, you can never get enough of it. Like Ashwini, as I told you, Ashwini indicates duality, things in two. Bharani is multiplicity, things in multiple numbers. So, like you know, Lagna Lord is in Bharani. Suppose Lagna indicates fame, and for this person, there is never enough of it. When positive, it will indicate that the fame will keep on increasing day by day. When Bharani is negative, then it will indicate that no matter however hard he try, he will never be able to reach that level, right? What is a positive Bharani and a negative Bharani? So when benefic planets are situated in a nakshatra, it is positive. Benefic such as Moon, Mercury, Jupiter, Venus. When malefics are situated in a nakshatra, Rahu, Ketu, Saturn, Mars, Sun, it is negative. So Bharani can indicate both the parts. Either something which is constantly increasing day by day, there's never enough of it, or something which always falls short, there's nowhere enough of it. This is indicated by Bharani. Point one, right from the female reproductive organ thing. Second thing that needs to be understood. Shankaracharya have talked very badly about the conditions of the soul in the womb of mother. And looking at it, the child, since he gets the consciousness, wants to be free out of the womb, wants to get out of the womb. And Shankaracharya have specifically mentioned it as, you know, like it is a bad place to be in, right? That is the stomach of the mother. Although it is highly glorified, but at the same point of time, it is not very much glorified, because at the end of the day, it is the stomach where everything is there, and it is kind of a filthy situation, right? When the placenta breaks, there is a whole lot of fluid, etc., coming out, that is not considered very good. So Bharani also indicates an uneasy situation. Bharani indicates that there is an uneasy situation, and the person wants to be free. The person wants to be free from that uneasy situation. Bharani is a challenging nakshatra. It is a challenging nakshatra for everyone. Even if the Bharani is positive, even in that case also, the challenge of that I want to break this thing out, that I want to break this condition and go out of this scenario, is something very important with Bharani. Do you understand my point? I will show you a horoscope. This is a horoscope, right? One of the clients. In this horoscope, you can find that the Jupiter and Moon is in Bharani. First of all, the nakshatra of Moon itself is very prominent. The nakshatra of Moon itself is considered very, very prominent. Along with this, this horoscope being Cancer Lagna, the Moon in Bharani is even more important because Moon is also the Lagna. The nakshatra of Moon, the nakshatra of Sun, the nakshatra of Lagna Lord, and the nakshatra of Ascendant, these four nakshatras are very important. So the Lagna Lord, Moon, and this, and Moon also, like Moon as a significator and Moon as the Lord of Lagna being in Bharani, does indicate that this person in such a situation where he wants to break free. This person is in such a situation which is not very conducive. The person himself wants to come out of this situation. Moon indicating mind, his mind is in extreme pressure and his mind wants to come out. Right? The whole life. See, the ascendant in gives you a synopsis of the whole life. Ascendant Lord in Bharani, his whole life is being in a restrict. See, the womb of the mother is a very restrained, very restricted space. This restriction, this jail kind of situation is indicated by Bharani. So his whole life, his complete life is restricted. And he wants to come out of that restriction. Getting my point? Along with this, there is Jupiter in Bharani as well. This Jupiter is the Lord of the sixth house. Enmity, competition, diseases, court cases, and affairs will also create such circumstances in his life that he wants to come out of it. Take Bharani, such situation, a condition from which you want to break free, and take the Lordship, right? Along with this, Jupiter is also the Lord of the ninth house. So his fortune, ninth house indicates fortune. His fortune is also restricted. And this person will want to break free. And at the end, this combination is happening in the 10th house. So in his profession also, and in his karma, 10th house also indicates karma. In his karma also, he will be in such a situation from where he will want to break free. Right? So just using one nakshatra, you can make a whole lot of predictions as I have done right now. So this is what Bharani is, right? By the symbology. After this, Bharani is lauded by Yama. Yama is the god of death. And god of death will punish you. And this is not because of a problem that you have done in this life. This is not because of something that you have done in this life. This is because of something that you have done in the previous life. So Bharani also indicates unnecessary punishment. Generally, the planet in Bharani, in the area of those planets, you will suffer a lot and you will not know the reason of suffering. The reason of suffering will be unknown to you. You will do all the good karmas, but still there will be suffering because of Bharani. Bharani indicates a bad karma from the previous life. And in the signification of that planet that is in Bharani, you will be punished unnecessarily. You will be punished without any reason. Bharani is a type of anger of God. Understood my point? But Bharani also gives you knowledge. Bharani also gives you intellect. So there is a very prominent thing. Yama Nachiketa Samvad. Have you heard of it? So there was a child of a sage named Nachiketa. And his father was doing a yajna and he was donating everything. So Nachiketa asked his father, why you are donating things? He said, to please the gods, I am donating everything that is very close to me. So he told his father that I am also close to you. Donate me. And then there was a whole lot of debate, etc. In the end, Nachiketa went to the home of Yama. And Yama is not there because Yama is an extremely busy guy. So take this point. Bharani is extremely busy. Whichever planet is in Bharani, at least one signification of that planet is always activated. 10th Lord in Bharani, high pressure of work. 11th Lord in Bharani, person is always running to fulfill his desires. One desire completes, new desire comes. Right? Constantly working on that area. That house is constantly activated. That is a positive side of Bharani as well as a negative side of Bharani. 6th Lord in Bharani, person is constantly suffering from one disease or the other. Getting my point? So the thing of Bharani is constantly activated. A 5th Lord in Bharani person is having multiple children, one child after another, constantly activated. Yama is 24/7 on run. Yama doesn't sit idle. He have a buffalo and he keeps on running on that buffalo. So Nachiketa stands outside the home of Yama and waits for him for 3 days. And after 3 days, Yama comes, and as Nachiketa is a Brahmin, he gives him food, etc. and asks Nachiketa to ask for some wish. But Nachiketa will not ask anything. Nachiketa wants a debate. Nachiketa wants to know about the secret of life and death. And Yama actually tells him the secret of life and death. That is also something that comes with Bharani knowledge. Whichever planet is in Bharani, the person is well read. Bharani is well read. If he is not well read in a traditional sense, if he is not holding a degree in the subject, doesn't matter. The person's intellect, the person's knowledge, in those things, signified by the planet in Bharani, will be of high level. For an example, Sun in Bharani. The person may not be a student of politics, but he will have great insight on politics. He will know very well how to rule people. He will know very well how to misguide people. Or whatever you say. Right, this knowledge comes from Bharani. For an example, see the horoscope of Adolf Hitler. He is having Venus and Mars in Bharani. Mars indicates warfare, war, fight, the tactics of war. Adolf Hitler is well learned in that. Adolf Hitler haven't studied war in any school, but he is very adept in war. Mars in Bharani. And of Venus. Venus is also in Bharani. So he is very adept in the things of Venus. Venus is loving your homeland also. Venus also indicates a strong love towards homeland. Well versed in that as well, right? Bharani indicates knowledge. The person will be well versed in the things signified by Bharani. Well versed in the things which is signified by the planet who is situated in Bharani. Okay. Along with this, along with this, there is few more aspects to Yama. Bharni have one more trait. You know, Bharni have one more trait. At least one of the relatives for Bharni, at least one of your own family member have done very bad in your life. Bharni. One of your own family member will do something very bad in your life. Why? Yama loved his father so much. And he found out that the mother, the lady that his father is living with, is not his original mother. So he told this thing to his father and kicked his mother. And because Yama kicked his mother, there was a curse on Yama that your leg will not work. This story is sometime given to Saturn, sometime given to Yama. This part one of the story. So at least one of the parents will do injustice to the Bharni person. At least, and when it is of other planets, one of the higher authorities. Don't take it as parent, take it as an higher authority. So higher authority will do something very bad with you. If the sixth lord is in Bharni, wrong decision in court. You are not guilty, but you will be proved guilty by mistake. Wrong decision. Right? Something unfair will happen. That is the first thing. Understood my point? Along with this, Bharani, lauded by Yama, Yama have a daughter Yamuna. And there is a story in Vedas that Yamuna told Yama that I am your sister. And I am having a desire for copulation. You should copulate with me as you are my brother. You should fulfill my wish. But Yama refuses it. And in return, Yamuna tells him to die. So Yama is the lord of death because he is the first one to die. Bharani, as I told you before, is activated right from the birth. The loss of Bharani from very childhood. Secondly, you know the part that I want to say, right? His own relatives are being very unfair to him. People very close will be, people very close to this, to Bharani, people very close to you will be the biggest one to cheat. Getting my point? That is what does Bharani indicates. And Yama is cursed to die. That is an indicative of the injustice that is happening with Bharani. Along with this, because Yama refused to copulate with his own sister, anyone must have fallen prey. In front of sexuality, anyone will fall prey. But Yama exhibits complete control on his senses. Bharani have a positive aspect of complete control. Mars in Bharani, the person will have complete control on his anger. Complete control. You will never see such person shouting or yelling. Mercury in Bharani, complete control over speech. Sun in Bharani, complete control over ego. Moon in Bharani, complete control over mind and emotions. Complete control can also mean that this person can have the tears of crocodile. Because complete control, he can cry anytime, whenever he wants. So both aspects are there, right? Be careful about it. So few stories related to Yama. Now coming to the, and there are many more stories related to Yama. We have to go to a specific section related to stories, right? On the name Bharani and Yama. Coming to the mantra for Bharni is Yamasyav Bharni Apakarashantaha Parastadap Vahanto Avastad. Bharni is a nakshatra of Yama, the restrainer. And this restrainer aspect I have already told you, right? Restrainer, the Bharni is a restricted condition. Whichever planet is in Bharni, in the scenario of that planet, you are restricted. Many a times, I face a question. Sir, I am repeatedly getting to see number 9. You must have also heard such repetitions, right? Sir, wherever I go, I repeatedly see the number 9. You know, so one day, the guy who drives our vehicle, he was telling me that, bhaiya, since last 1 month, at least once a day, I watch a new car. New car just coming out of showroom without number plate. This repetition is activation of Bharni. Things are being, because it is restricted, getting a point, it is restricted. 10th Lord in Bharni. And suppose you are a doctor. So you are only getting patients who are negligible about their medication. Getting my point. 9th Lord in Bharni. All your superiors are having the same ascendant as your father. All your superiors are having the same habit as your father. Getting my point? Bharni is repetition. I will explain it in a particular way. You know what? Adolf Hitler is having his Venus. Venus is the Karka for wife, right? Venus and Mars in Bharni. Mars is the 7th Lord and Venus is the 7th Karaka, right? Bharni. What does Bharni indicate? Repetition. All the women he have been, all the women Adolf Hitler have been in relationship with, all of them committed suicide. Repetition. Getting my point? All of them committed suicide. All of them had a violent death. This repetition is what is Bharni. Getting my point? This repetition comes from Bharni. Everyone is the same. Okay. That is the restrainer. It doesn't only restrict your growth. I have explained the restriction in a way in starting, right? See, one word will have multiple meanings. So when I was talking of restriction before, what I told you that it is a very uneasy condition, right? Restriction is a very uneasy condition, something from which you want to break free. That is restriction one. That is restriction one. Another restriction is the same thing being repeated again and again. Getting my point? That is also restriction. Yamasya apabharni. Bharni means carrying away. Taking something and carrying it away. So you know what? Bharni, as I told you, you know, I explained this carrying away before. When I told you that Bharni indicates punishment. And that punishment is not because something that you have done bad in this life. You know, no woman. Hitler only dated one lady. Other just fell in his love. So he was never responsible. Getting my point? Was he responsible? No. He was not responsible. It indicates bearing something, carrying away something. And as I told you before, this indicates there is a punishment in Bharni. And that punishment is being carried away from the past life. Right? That is one thing. And second thing, you know what? Bharani have a pattern. Getting my point? Bharani indicates a pattern. For an example, you know, the Bharani is what I will say, the curse of lineage. Bharani is the... Do you want to know why you are born in a particular family? There can be this question, right? That's why I am born in this particular family. From which house you see? Seventh house. Check your seventh house and seventh lord. The traits of that house will be in your family. Sun in the seventh house, someone from your family will be related to politics or power, or actually many people. Some or the other signification of sun have to be there. So say grandfather was into politics and father was into timber business. Timber business once again indicated by sun. Getting my point? Moon in the seventh house. Women are very prominent in your family. Women are very prominent in your family. Women are taking multiple decisions. There's a story of woman eloping away with people. Moon indicates elopement. History. Mars in the seventh house. There is an army military history in the family. Or anger issues are a history in family. Getting my point? Seventh house is the key. Why you are born in a particular family? I have my seventh lord son with Jupiter. My maternal grandfather used to wake up at 4 in the morning and start reading Bhagavad Gita. My paternal grandfather, astrologer, my father, astrologer, my paternal uncle, astrologer, whole family, astrologer, right? Seventh lord with Jupiter. Why you are born in a particular family, seventh house? Now you know what? If you have to see this, you have to see this. If a planet is connected to the heart. If a planet is, you know, say, let me explain it in a better way. There is something that I will mention at the curse in the family. Curse in the family. Let me tell you one thing. Jupiter in the seventh house. Okay. Jupiter in the seventh house indicates that your ancestors have made a temple. And no one is taking care of that temple now. And the difficulties in life is because of that temple. And generally, it will be from the mother's side. You should ask. So, you know, this curse of lineage, because of that temple, because of the negligence of that temple, there will be hardships in the life of the siblings. Hardship in the life of people, or rather say the same type of fate. The same type of fate, getting my point? If both the brother divorced, both the brother died in accident, getting my point? The same type of curse, both the brother having no children, both the brother suffering from disease. The curse in the lineage is indicated by Bharani. So there are, first of all, why you are born in a family, seventh house. I'm giving you a big secret that I should not be giving out, by the way. But still, because we are talking of Bharani. Okay. Why you are born in this particular family, the seventh house. If the same planet is connected, just a second, Vikiji. If a same planet is connected to the seventh house of your chart, seventh house of your brother's chart, then that is a curse. Okay. But how to, suppose you are a brother, you are a client and you don't have a brother's chart, you don't have a brother. Either you don't have a brother or you don't have your brother's chart. Getting my point? In that scenario, how do I find the curves in the lineage? First of all, it is not important that there should be a curse in the lineage, first of all. Okay? If you don't have planet in the seventh house, no worry, no tension. You know what? Planet in the seventh house is never appreciated. Planet in the seventh house is not appreciated in Prashna. Planet in the seventh house is not appreciated in Muhurta. Planet in the seventh house is not appreciated in the natal chart. Even seventh lord in seventh house will have defect. Exalted planet 7,000 defect, debilitated planet 7,000 defect. It is a standard rule of astrology that no planet, three houses, no planet are appreciated. 7th house, 8th house, 3rd house. No planet is appreciated. Every planet is bad. Especially the 7th house. No planet is appreciated in the 7th house. It will create a curse. It will create a problem. So it is not necessary that everyone should have a curse. Empty 7th house, no problem. Tension free. In that scenario, check the 7th lord and then you decide what type, what is, why you are born in this particular family. If there is a planet in the 7th house, also check the same planet influencing the 7th house of your siblings, of your mother, father, parents, etc. But if you cannot check the chart, check Bharani. Planet in Bharani, curse is there. And generally, you know what? Generally, planet in Bharani, such person is very affluent or very successful. Ask me why. Because God doesn't want, you know, there is something very special with curse. There is something very special with any type of curse, you know. You know what is that special thing? The person is extremely successful, generally. There can be two things. Either the person is extremely successful or the person is into multiple problems. The prime point is that the God doesn't want you to pay attention to that curse. So either it will make you extremely successful, you will not be able to see the curse, or you will be in so many problems that you will not be able to think of the curse. Getting my point? Either of the ways, your focus on that curse will never be there. And for this particular reason, you should know, as that's the only reason we come to astrology. What is told in classics? That astrology, lights, astrology is like a light, a lamp in a room which is dark. So when you light a lamp in the room which is dark, you can see the objects kept there. Getting my point? Generally, what will happen, there will be a curse in the chart and you will not be able to see it until and unless you can do something about it. When you are a child, you will see the effect of the curse. When you will grow up, that curse will disappear. And you know when it will come back? At the end time, when you are about to die. It will come in the childhood, you cannot do anything. And it will come when you have left your job, when now you are an old guy. Getting my point or not? Like Hitler is having it in the 7th house. His curse is coming when? When he is in the bunker. Now he cannot do anything about that curse, right? He have to die in that bunker. He have to succumb to death. Jab tak aap apni madad kar sakte hain, tab tak aapko curse nahi dikhega. The day you will become weak enough that you cannot change it, that day that curse will open. Remember it. Curses are like snake. A snake will never try to eat an animal who is running. Will snake eat an animal who is running? No. Snake will eat an animal who is resting. Curse will come when you are resting. When you cannot do anything. Then snake will come to bite. Yes, Vikit.
Sir, I mean, I was just requesting, 7th house ke aapne jo topic bula hai, bahut hi alag hai. If you could tell us about the other planets too.
एंड सर वो 7th हाउस का सीरीज करेंगे तुम देखेंगे
ठीक है सर
अभी भरनी है तो भरनी
का इसमें अगर कोई प्लैनेट भरनी में जैसे ये क्या बोलते हैं मांडी वगैरह आ जाए वी लुक एट द लॉर्ड फॉर इट के मांडी के
मांडी इटसेल्फ इज अ ग्रेट कर्स मांडी हैव हिज ओन सिग्निफिकेशन ना मांडी इज इटसेल्फ अ ग्रेट कर्स इफ यू आर प्लैनेट्स लाइक मांडी एटसेट्रा देन इट इज अ बिग बिग प्रॉब्लम
जी
एंड स्पेसिफिकली व्हेन देयर आर प्लैनेट्स लाइक मांडी धूमा व्यतिपात इन दैट सिनेरियो यू नो द कर्स इज यू कैन सी इट फ्रॉम योर ओपन आईज लेट मी टेल यू आई नो अ केस विद मांडी इन भरनी And this Bharani is in the this is in the 8th house. Okay. So it is a Virgo ascendant. And there is Mandi. 8th house, Aries, right? And there is Mandi in there. You know what is the problem? No person in their home is interested in worship. So he is a Hindu. His father married a Muslim lady. Now both the child are Muslim. Okay. And none of no person in their home worships or even think of God. Not even of Allah. You see, I have no problem. You can be a Hindu, you can be a Muslim. Personal preference. Masjid to jao, bhai. Kahin to jao. No Hindu religious activity, no Muslim religious activity. Getting my point? The thing is in front of you. In front of you, you just need to open and to open an eye. But you know, many times we are blind. We are blind. Some person will be beating his wife. Some person will be abusing his wife. And he will ask astrologer, sir, what bad karma I have done? You are beating your wife. Don't you see it is a bad karma? Yeah, you are not happy you divorced. You are not happy get separated. I know a person. He is beating his wife every day. It is not like the person is drunkard, etc. No. He is beating the wife and he is telling that I beat you because like you know that kinky fantasy stuff is whatever there. He beats his wife. Sometime in anger, sometime in love, etc. And he keeps on visiting astrologer and he is asking, sir, what bad karma I have done? Why I am suffering? The suffering is in front of you. You are not able to see. That's what happened when you are in anger. When you are in anger, you cannot see even the truth in front of you. Yeah, what you say in anger? Arey, jo hoga ho jayega yaar, chhod. Ab pata hai ki ho jayega. Mere gusse mein nahi. Arey, hata. Hata nahi, bete, hata nahi. Ghum ke aayega woh. Karma is a boomerang. It will go right now. It will come back. To understand that boomerang is important, right? So pending karma thing, some other day, some other class, some other course. Why to teach something for free?
Yes, sir.
Nah, we'll do. We'll do so. Okay. So Bharani is that curse. Okay. Yamasya ap Bharani apakarshantah drawing away. So this is what is in Bharani. Apakarshanta, the word apakarshanta in the mantra is drawing away. Bharani have a very specific tendency of, as I told you, in the story. See, remember something. You are learning astrology from which guy? Subham Aluk. Or if you are watching it on YouTube, you are on whose channel? Subham Aluk. My friend, either I do something serious or I sleep. Be very simple about it, right? No time pass. Serious. Stuff. Okay. So, stories, anecdote, anything that I am telling you is having a deep, deep meaning. Getting my point? A guru or a teacher is not supposed to joke. Is he supposed to crack a joke? No. Anything, even if I say it in a joking sense, has some meaning. So, right now, what we were talking about, negligence, right? So, that is in the mantra, Yamasya Apbharni Apkarshanta. Apakarshanta means drawing away. Bharani have the tendency of drawing away the attention. You know what? The planet in Bharani, there will be great problem related to that planet. But that will never come to your eyes, never come in front of your eyes. whichever planet is in Bharani, you will think that I am right. In that particular area, you will think that you are right. That is the problem with Bharani. Your thinking that you are right is problem. That thing, you know, Mercury in Bharani, the person will do big blunder and big mistakes while speaking. And he will be able to see all of his defect, but he will not be able to see his speech defect or the defect related to Mercury. Do you get my point? Bharani is an indicative of drawing away the attention. The attention is never there on Bharani. Bharani is hidden. See, it is the female reproductive organ, and in the Saptashati, it is told that Swayo Niriva Parvati. Parvati, hide it like women do. Women hide their reproductive organ. So that hidden aspect is there. You know, there you will never focus on the planet that is in Bharani, and that is the problem. Getting my point? That is something which needs to be kept extremely clean. Whichever planet is in Bharani, you have to be very clean in the signification of that planet. Getting my point or not? Female organ, once again, private organ should be kept extremely clean. Right? Be very, seventh lord in Bharani, very clean of character. Their problem happen, life will go haphazard. Fourth lord in Bharani, give comfort to everyone. If you ever plan to snatch anyone's comfort away, if you think that no, he is my enemy, let me do something that he will be in tension. Getting my point? Even if you like, you know, even if you take your garbage and place it in front of your neighbor's home, if the third lord or fourth lord is in Bharani, or the tenth lord is in Bharani, tenth house karma. Third house neighborhood and fourth house home, so your home, other's home. Even if you take your garbage and keep it in front of anyone's home, Bharani gone. And then what? Bharani gives you punishment. Punishment of even the smallest mistake. Extreme level of purity. Purity from speech, purity from thought, and purity from actions. You know what? Brahmacharya, as I told you, Yama is restrainer. His sister told him to have copulation, he restrained. He had brahmacharya, he practiced brahmacharya. And brahmacharya is of three types: mental, physical, and on karma. So a complete brahmacharya is when you don't think of woman. Even when a woman, you know, like even if a naked woman is passing in front of you, you have no physical changes. And you don't even desire it. So no desire by mind, no desire by body, and no desire by soul is what brahmacharya is like. So Bharani, all three level of, you know, not even teasing anyone by thought, neither by speech, nor by actions. Getting my point? So there are going to be three things. I fight with my neighbor. Verbal. I put my garbage in front of their gate, physical. Or I plan how to kill this dog. Isko bori mein band karke phenk denge bahar. Mental. So karma is mental, physical, verbal. Any type of karma you do, it is a bad karma. And let me tell you, mental karma is worst. Physical karma is second worst. Sorry, speech karma is second worst. Physical karma is least. Physical karma is least. Verbal karma, two times more. And mental karma, three times more. Who is the real culprit of a murder? The one who planned it. The one who planned it is the real culprit, right? Because he planned who needs to be murdered, who will murder, how we will murder. Getting my point? Yes. So who is the culprit? Because it is Yama, and Yama is related to death. Gruesome crime. Okay, going further. Yamasya apabharnihi apakarshanta parastad hanto avastad. So once again, the caring moving. You know what? The power of Bharani. Okay, so let me give you one more example in a toned down world. So, you know, if a person is in sexuality, why sexuality is considered very bad in Shastras? Why it is considered very bad? Why Brahmacharya is highly emphasized? Because, you know what, when someone is thinking sexually, he is not able to think in any other way. Right? You will like completely agree to it. So there is a saying that there is blood flow only at a particular point. Either your mind is working or your hand is working. So it is generally is what I told in anger. Regarding anger, I will always tell that, my friend, blood can flow in one direction. Either it will go to your mind and you will think, or it will go to your hand and you will fight. So you decide you want the blood flow in your mind or in your hands. That's why I never beat anyone. Because I want blood flow in my mind, not in my hands or any other body part for that matter.
Right.
That's why, you know what, walking in the morning is considered a great way of meditation. Blood flow in the legs, mind not working. Getting my point? So there is blood flow at only at a particular particular area. And when someone thinks of sexuality, he is carried away by sexual thoughts. Getting my point? He's carried away. And that being carried away is also signified by Bharani. So whichever planet is in Bharani, the signification of that planet is that powerful that you are carried away. Moon in Bharani. You think, sir, I am right. I was always right. I think that you should behave in this particular way and I am right. Getting my mind? This is what Bharani is. So you know when any person comes to you and says, sir, see my chart. And you tell, brother, take a consultation. Like, why you are taking money? I'm like, because I have a family. So I have to take money. No, astrologer should not take money. Bharani, carried away by his own thoughts. Listen to my part of the story. Everyone have a part of the story, isn't it? So that is what goes with Bharani. No, you should not do it. Who are you to decide what I should be doing? Isn't it my duty? Your life, your duty, my life, my duty. But that is Bharani, you know, being carried away. And, you know, in the second part of the course, this is a part of my nakshatra course that is about to start. Okay, so this is a part of my nakshatra course. And in the second part of course, when I will talk about the classical result for nakshatras, you will see how subtly these significations are given there. You know, Bharani person is told a thief. You know, in astrological world, people steal techniques. Yeah. Someone will watch technique from one video and he will make another video. This stealing comes in Bharani. Carried away. Getting my point. Taking it and carrying away. Stealing. That comes from Bharani. Right? You know, there is generally a case, you know, like, sir, this lady lured my boyfriend. Bharani, carried away. Stealing, theft comes in Bharani. So it can be theft of an idea, theft of money, theft of anything. Yeah, plagiarism. A lot of plagiarism comes with Bharani. Two idea from this video, three idea from this video, four idea from this video, my video. This is what happens with Bharani. Okay. And now coming to the stories of Yama. Coming to the stories of Yama. Yama is Vyavasthapak. Yama is the one who is in the duty of maintaining the rule. See, what is the duty of Yama? The duty of Yama is to keep a check. Is to keep a check that the population of the world doesn't exceed. That is the duty of Yama, right? And this comes from Bharani also. So Bharani, the lesson of Bharani is things in the right amount. And generally, you will see the planet in Bharani, that thing is in extreme. For an example, Hitler, Venus in Bharani. Everyone should love their motherland. Everyone should. But that love have to be in an amount, in a quantity. And that quantity was not there for Hitler. And so this extremity. I told this before also. And Yama is also an architect. Yama is an architect. Right? Yama is an architect, and generally, whichever planet is in Bharani, you create something new in that thing. See, Adolf Hitler is having Mars in Bharani. New records in warfare, new records in fighting, torture, new records in torture. Have you heard about Nazi camps? What amount of torture he did? New records of torture. The old world formulas that people have forgot, he implemented once again. New architecture altogether. This way to tease, this way to punish. That is what comes into Bharani. You know, Bharani. Creating, planning, designing something new. Architecture. He's a Silpi, architect. Yama is architect. The person is very good. Planning comes from Bharani. 10th Lord in Bharani, the person will do a well-planned business. Very well-planned business. From day one, he will plan, I am going to teach astrology, but I don't know astrology, so I will not take consultation. So no one can say that my prediction is no consultation, okay, only teaching. Very good. Planning from day one, this should not be done. That is what comes in Bharani. But you know, there is the word Yama. What is the Anvyay? You know, there is something known as Anvyay. Anvyay is what? Breaking a word and understanding its meaning. That is Anvyay. And Anvyay for the word Yama is Yam plus Ach. That means in Hindi, Yam. वो व्यक्ति जो जीवों को उसके प्राणों से उपकार करता है. The one who gives freedom to the soul, freedom from the body. So Bharani is a type of transformation also. Bharani is losing away of unnecessary things, leaving those things which are not very important. See, birth and death are the two real truths in this life, right? Everything else is transitory. So the person is in a web of relationships, in a web of emotions, in a web of commitments, right? And the death takes you out from that web, right? All the family responsibility, professional responsibility, relationship responsibility, any type of responsibility, death takes you away from all the responsibilities, right? So that break in a moment, freeing away from everything, just one big bang and the complete freedom, is also indicated by Bharani. So, you know, as I told you, Bharani is a restrictive condition. The person is restricted. And because it indicates yoni and also the womb of the mother, the person wants to break free of the situation. That break free will surely come. That break free will come one day, and that will come, you know, like in spur of a moment. That break free will come in a spur of a moment. Freedom from all the tensions. One day. But that will be very painful because no one wants to die. But it will happen. So Bharani is never activated for a lifetime. Right? So Adolf Hitler once again, Mars in Bharani. So the torture that Adolf Hitler did to everyone came to an end. See, he was still on a war. He was still on a fight when Adolf Hitler committed suicide. If the war was on, the fight was on, he neither won, neither defeated. He thought that he sensed that he will get defeated. He sensed that he will get defeated. And he committed suicide. The war was going on. Everything was going on, and he committed suicide in between. Getting out of the scene in a moment. In a spur of a moment. Getting out of the scene in a spur of a moment. Someone who is saying, no, I will not dance, suddenly gets up and starts dancing. Kya hua tera vaada? Bhai, wo kasam, wo irada? All gone. Just a moment and you will be like, no, I will do it. Okay. This is what happens. That is what Bharani is. Getting my word. There comes the trait of cheating. I tell, no, no, sir, you trust me. I will always be on your home. No, no, I don't have the tendency of thieving. But one day, when you are not at home, take the cash, run. Surprise. Because, see, a thief cannot tell you that I will come to your home tomorrow to steal this particular thing. Surprise, surprise attack. That is what comes with Bharani. That's why he's a thief. Vara Mihir will tell you. Bharani mein paida hua jatak chor hota hai. For this particular reason. Stotaon ko, okay, so there is, he gives the desired things to those who worship him. Those who understand the Bharani. Those who understand Bharani, those who understand the working of Bharani, and specifically those who remain balanced, controlled in the signification of that planet that is in Bharani. Those who are very clear regarding the signification of the planet that is in Bharani. Suppose Mercury is in Bharani. So someone who is very controlled in his speech, very restricted in his speech, and very pure in his speech, to him, Bharani will give everything. Because Bharani is not only the emptiness of the female organ, it is also the fulfillment. Provided the fact that you are righteous, controlled in the matters of Bharani. Getting my point? So Venus in Bharani. If you are very good by character, then you have a very good wife. You lose your character. Because Bharani is what? Punishment. One bad karma you do and it will. Bharani is that type of punishment. You went to a club and watched a lady. Just for 2 minutes. It will result in divorce. A small mistake, big punishment. That is what Bharani is. Don't even do that small mistake. That small mistake will be very troublesome. Getting my word? Yam arthat madhyam sthayi vayu haya. Yama is the air that is in the middle of the body. The air that is from the heart portion to the upper stomach. The air that occupies the area from the lower heart, from the heart to the upper part of the stomach, is known as yama. So generally, if a Bharani is activated, there is generally problem in this particular area. From the lower part of the chest to the upper part of the stomach, you know, this particular area of chest, there is a problem if the Bharani is affected. Because Bharani is vayu. And what I told you about why, you know, what are the problems that Vayu create? Vayu is the one who will break down something. Okay. Vayu breaks down thing. So when Bharani is afflicted, there is a problem in breaking down. There is a problem in breaking down. Understanding the finer aspect is a problem. So, you know, Mercury in Bharani, as I told you, the person can be very bad in his speech because he doesn't understand the nuances of speech. He doesn't understand the finer aspects of speech. He doesn't understand how much problem speech can create. You get my point? And as per the karma of people, Yama gives them either the heaven or hell. So Bharani, as I told you, when I was talking of the karma, what I'm telling you that when there is a curse, it will hit you. It will bite you when you are not able to do. So, you can complain that, sir, I have Mercury in Bharani and I have never told bad to anyone. I have always treated everyone in a good way, but I have never gotten the good result. That good result you are going to get in end. That is what does Bharani indicate. Bharani is activated in the last part of life. You have read Godan of Munshi Premchand. That is what Bharani is. Getting my point? Third lord in Bharani, very bad relationship with the sibling. And the day your relationship will be happy with your siblings, understand that now is the time. So either the relationship will completely break after this. So it doesn't particularly mean death only, right? But so, you and your brother are living together. You are fighting every day. One day the relationship is very good. It remains good for 2 months. And after 2 months, your brother gets a job in foreign land. No relationship gone. That is what happens with Bharani. If you are very good, then Bharani will give you result in the end. If you are good with the traits of Bharani, it will reward you in the end. And if you are bad with the traits of Bharani, it will punish you every day. Because Yama, his desire. When the sun is about to set, that time is called Yama. That time is also known as Yama. So the setting of sun is very much related to death. So whichever planet is in Bharani, that planet is dying. I don't know if Hitler was having any siblings or not. If he had, they were of no use because Mars in Bharani. Right? So the particular signification or the emotion of the planet that is in Bharani that dies. Getting my point? As I told you before, Bharani is also knowledge. Bharani is also death. So you must have heard of people, like H.N. Carteret. Do you know H.N. Carteret? H.N. Carteret wrote a book on spiritual astrology. But he was a non-believer in God. He wrote a book on spiritual astrology and he was a non-believer in God. Suppose a pundit who is a non-believer in God. There is a philosophy that is known as Charvak philosophy. They don't believe in Vedas. But still there is philosophy. That is what is Bharani. The thing have died, but the knowledge is there. You don't believe in God, but you talk of spirituality and the combination for spirituality, Bharani. Getting my point? That also comes from Bharani, this particular aspect. And there are multiple things of Bharani that I will tell you in a nutshell. Right? The one who gives life is Bharani. The one who gives life is also known as Yama. Yama also means darkness. So, there is a darkness in the karma. I have already told you, right? Bharani indicates a bad karma done in the previous life, the curse. Okay. And the one who follows all the eight Yama, Niyama and Pranayama is also known as Yama. Why he is known as Yama? Because he follows Art Yam, Art Niyam, Art Pranayama. He follows the eight Yamas, eight Niyamas and eight Pranayams. That's why he is a Yama. He is completely according to the timetable. If it is 12:30, it is 12:30. Bharani. I have no pride in Bharani. Result in front of you. That Bharani is extremely obedient to his timetable. It is god of death, child of sun. It indicates restriction, control. It also indicates, you know, Vedic worship and Vedic rituals. You know, Bharani means one more. Yama means one more thing. Yama means your brother who is born with you. Bharani indicates something that is born with you or something that will die with you. Bharani indicates this particular. As I told you, Ashwini. Ashwini is Amar. Ashwini will live even after death. Bharani is something that will die with you. You know, there is a particular branch or a particular thinking which is only there till the person is there. Once he dies, that knowledge will go. That knowledge will disappear, right? Knowledge or work, etc. will disappear. You must have seen there was a very good guru, and that guru made an institution. And as soon as the guru died, his students took over the institution, and now that institution is all gone. Right? The institution have been deteriorated. The values of the institution have deteriorated. That is indicated by Bharani. Something that bonds with you, something that dies with you. All the values, rules, and regulations that you have implemented will die once you die. Bharani will not die alone. Everything will die with him. So generally, you know what? Seventh Lord in Bharani, you and your spouse die together. Getting my point? So this is a horoscope of a person, you know. This is a horoscope of a person. He was traveling to some place. It was Sunday. He and his wife were going to a place for vacation. Car met with an accident. Both husband and wife died together. Eighth Lord Saturn in Bharani. Fourth Pada Moksha. We learned that yesterday, right? First Pada Dharma, second Pada Earth, third Pada Kama, fourth Pada. So differentiation. Whether Bharani will give you a very good timetable, Dharma, or it will give you punishment. Punishment by, see, first Pada Dharma. Very good timetable by Bharani. Artha. You are struggling for your basic desires to get fulfilled. It is not getting fulfilled. Artha. Kama. Your wishes and desires are let down and there is a curse. And moksha, for the death indication of Yama. Right. So based on the pada, which quality will be dominant, you decide based on the pada, right? Died together. Yama is something which is born together, something which will die together. It indicates, so Ashwini was a female bond in marriage. Bharani is a male bond in marriage. So Ashwini Bharani are technically a couple, both opposite. Ashwini is opposite of Bharani, Bharani is opposite of Ashwini. Right? Now coming to my notes complete. Now coming to the last part of it. Padas of Bharani and Karmas of Bharani. So first of all, Bharani first pada. Bharani first pada is specifically marked by anger, frustration, greed, and added to that, you know, there is a policy, food dalo rajguru, separation and rule. That is Bharani first pada. High level of ego, great anger. The person is, you know, like, is aiming very high. The aim is extremely high, big aim, high aim. Always under-delivered, under-promised. Divide and rule is the policy. And this person is not fit for the society where he is belonging to. Extremely unfit. If he is spiritual, he is in a materialistic place. If he is materialistic, he is in a spiritual place. A strong desire that I should run to jungle. I should run to some place because I doesn't belong to this particular place is what comes with the first pada of burning. Okay. Along with this, the person will be aggressive. He will have small eyes, the first pada of burning. The eyes will be small. Right. His nose will be very prominent, fat, bulky nose. Right. His eyebrows will be thick. His forehead will be very wide. He will have a bit, I will not say fat, a bit healthy in body. Specifically, the hips, stomach region will have a great amount of flesh. Carbohydrate technically coming out of, you know, so generally there are people who just getting fat over few particular areas in body, not over the complete body. That is what is indicated by Bharani. And their hairs are not very good to touch. Like, you know, the hair is not very good in texture. So have to keep, take care of their hair is what is indicated by Bharani first pada. Okay. Now coming to Bharani second pada. Bharani second pada, first of all, speech is a big problem. If speech is a big problem, the person is dirty. Dirty either by appearance or by management or by a particular thought. There is Bharani second pada is with a lot of conflict. Mind wants something else, heart wants something else, you do something else. Complete unfocused. Lack of focus. Generally, it will come with skin disease and problems related to speaking, normally misunderstood. Along with being misunderstood, marital life is, I will not say problematic, I will say non-satisfactory. Okay. So marital life is non-satisfactory. And but the person is intelligent, quick, witty, knowledgeable, and very good in mathematics and calculation. Marriage is late. Generally, the person will marry late. And the spouse, the couple, the person as a couple, can have everything, but you know, he will not be able to satisfy their spouse generally in at least one of the term of the marital life, either financially or physically, whatever you think. This strong dissatisfaction in at least one part of the marital life is what is indicated. Talking of the person will be a bit dark in complexion, soft in disposition, and like soft spoken. He will have big eyes, specifically wide from the middle area, right? He will be tall, have problems related to stomach disorder, and gastric troubles can be there. Along with this, he will be a bit timid to fight. He will not fight easily, and he will generally be frustrated of almost everything. So, you know, it is a kind of a perfectionist guy who want everything to, like, you know, like Bharani second pada, bhaiya wahan chalo, kahan chalo, wahan chalo, wahin chalo, getting my point. So Bharani second pada is, he wants something to happen. He wants something to be done in a particular way, and he is unable to express how to do it. And when you do it for him, he will be like, oh, it is not done in a good way. Let me do it once again. That is what Bharani second pada is. Okay. Fine. Coming to the third pada of Bharani, extreme passion, sensuality, sexuality, focus. You know, like Bharani second pada, third pada, sorry. Bharani third pada specifically. You know that trait of, I told you, know, blood flow is only in one particular area, not every particular area. This is the third pada of Bharani. the person is only able to focus at one point of, at one thing at a point of time. So if he is making money, he is only making money, his personal life is going bad. If his personal life is going good, then he is not able to make money. Focus only at one point, one place. The person generally will be carried away by thoughts. The person will generally be carried away by his thinkings and thought, and his mind is one of the biggest problems, right? He is carried away by almost every idea. The person will not practice discrimination. He will listen to everyone and will follow everyone. It is very difficult for this person to make his own mark or, you know, like make his own statement. The person is generally highly influenced by other things. His own stand, his own thought, his free thinking is almost absent. There are problems in family, specifically in the paternal side. At least one member from the paternal side may have died unexpected death. The relationship with the father or the relationship between father and the grandfather is not very harmonious. Right? The person is generally challenged by his own family members, own wife, children, etc. Right? Person is generally what you will say sexually frustrated or will repress his desires. But at the same point of time, the person is very much obedient, very soft-spoken. The person will, you know, stick to a timetable. He will generally have a very good health. Many things will not disturb his health often. But accident is a, like, you know, accidents is like pattern. Accident is a pattern. The person generally every second day or third day will be in big or small accident, at least will be involved in a big or small accident. The person, you know, his skin, the veins of the body will be visible through his skin. So generally fair complexion, right? He will be fickle minded. He will not be able to, as I told you before, he will not be able to think at a thought very strongly, right? His eyes will be good, beautiful to look at, right? His marital life, as I told you before, is not very good. His marital life will be bad, specifically the ways and behavior of his wife. He himself doesn't like the behavior of his wife. He is the biggest critic of his spouse, generally. Right. That was the third pada. The fourth pada is good. The fourth pada of Bharani is good. All the bad results of Bharani will only come in the end of the life. The middle part and the first part of the life is very good. The person is generally secretive. He will not tell multiple things. He will try to hide many things. He has a huge emotions. He has huge, huge emotions. And he will not share that emotion with anyone. You know, this is a person who is like very cold-blooded. He will plan something for very long and will implement it one day. This is a person which will look, you know, very calm and very, yeah, generally very calm and very docile, but is a cold-blooded murderer kind of a person who is planning things in the background and will one day will come up, and that will be a big problem, right? Generally, if it is your chart, then you may have such trait and you cannot become a problem for yourself, but you are generally a problem for other people. And the real crux of astrology is to understanding yourself, getting my point. Understanding yourself is the real crux of astrology. Like I am an Aquarius Lagna, I have Aries in my third house. So accepting that my speech is not very good, that I really hurt people by my speech, is the biggest realization that you can get through astrology, right? And that is what is needed. That's why you should learn astrology. You should know about astrology. Coming back to, yes, Amarkanji, John Wick. Varni fourth pada, John Wick. Yeah. Okay. Along with this, Bharani fourth pada, the person is generally having, his mother's health is not very good. Relationship with mother is not very good. He have a, like, you know, second mother kind of a scenario is what I will say. So generally the person is taken care of by maternal or paternal grandparents, someone who is very close to maternal or paternal grandparents, generally maternal family, maternal side of the family, he will be very close. Very close to maternal uncle, or you know, like the maternal uncle or maternal aunt or maternal grandfathers will play the role of parents in the life of this particular person. Right? He is very, you know, he's very haphazard in his thought, he's very haphazard in his thinking. Focus, concentration is a problem. And generally, this is known as Saap-Sheers kind of a scenario. Okay, this is known as a Saap-Sheers kind of a scenario. Saap-Sheers means the person is, when the person is born, you know, the Bharani Fourth Pandar. When the person is born, he is already from birth. He is burdened with many expectations and many, you know, he right from birth, he is burdened with many expectations and many things that he needs to do. And his complete life will go on just to tick those, you know, criteria. The person is already overburdened and laden with multiple things that he have to achieve in multiple criteria, and he have to, you know, it is like he's the youngest brother and he's always compared to his elder brother, and he have to, getting my point, he have to do how his brother have done, you know. So someone who is constantly under pressure, do it that way, do it that way. That kind of a scenario is indicated by Bharani Fourth Pada. Right? The Bharani Fourth Pada is the person is beautiful, but you know what? Bharani Fourth Pada, he cannot look at something straight. Sometime he will look here, sometime there, you know, like it is told as a having a monkey type of a thing. So he is sometime reading about Vastu, sometime reading about astrology, sometime reading about numerology. No, not contented with one particular thing, jumping from one field to another field, one area to another area, is a very good marked trait. Beautiful to look at, very influential in speaking, very good in speech, very melodious voice, can be interested in music, etc. as well. He will be thin, with a well-built body, but will be allergic to a few things, strongly allergic to multiple things. And even a small change in his timetable, even a small change in his schedule can create multiple problems in his life. Generally, this person will only get losses if he is connected to foreign land or people from foreign land in any way. He will have only losses, and huge, huge losses he will have. Right? Generally, it does indicate sexual diseases, specifically disease related to not being able to produce child or not being able to control the bodily fluids. The person will get tortured in life. The person will get tortured and blackmailed in life, and he will be interested in torturing and blackmailing other people also. Or somehow he will behave in a particular way, which will be torturous for the other person. The person will be a like liar. He will not try to speak a truth, or rather, you know, I tell liar in a better way. He will mold the real truth, or he will not tell everything as it is. He will, you know, like try to add some own fantasy in a storyteller, a good storyteller, you know. Okay. He will be fond of his friends. He will be very close to his friend, will have a good friend circle, but generally his friends will only cheat him. Right, and he will be aggressive. Mm-hmm. Okay. So that's all about Bharani. If you are watching in the class on YouTube, I am doing a series on nakshatras. And if you want to know about the next nakshatra, what you have to do? Subscribe the channel, right? That is what needs to be done. And thank you for watching. We will meet in the next class regarding Kritika.